Hello everyone, in this lecture we will discuss about unity gate, sampler or buffer. Now, while a unity gain amplifier can be realized with no resistor and capacitor as shown in this figure 38 in the feedback network, but for discrete time application it still requires a sampling circuit. We therefore consider the circuit shown in figure B30B as a sampler and buffer. However, the input dependent charge injected by this S1 onto this CH limit the accuracy there. So now we consider the another topology as shown in figure 31A, where the three switches control the sampling as well as amplification mode. The three switches are S1, S2 and S3. In the sampling mode, S1 and S2 are on and S3 is off, which yields the topology as shown in this figure 31B. And Vout is equals to Vx, which is 0, and the voltage across this CH tracks this Vin. At t equals to t0, Vin is equals to V0, and S1 and S2, these two turn off and S3 turns on, which lead to this topology as shown in this figure C. Clipping the capacitor around the op amp and entering the circuit into the amplification mode. Okay, now with proper timing, the circuit of figure 31A can substantially alleviate the problem of channel charge injection. Okay, now as in figure 32 shown over here, that illustrate a slow motion, that is during the transition from the sampling mode to the amplification mode, S2 turns off slightly before S1 does, as shown in over here. S2 turns off, it injects a charge packet del Q2 onto this CH, which produces an error equal to del Q2 by CH. However, this charge is independent of the input level because node X is a virtual ground. Okay, now our study of this figure 31A thus far suggests that with proper timing, the charge injected by S1 and S3 is unimportant, and channel charge of S2 result in a constant offset voltage. Now, figure 34 depicts a simple realization of the clock edges to ensure that S1 turns off as after S2 does. Okay, as shown over here, we have used this inverter. Okay, and we connected to both this S1 and S3. For simultaneously off of this S1 and S2. Now the input independent nature of the charge injected by the reset switch allows complete cancellation by differential path. So here we have shown the generation of proper clock edges for unity gain sampler. And illustrated in this figure 35, such an approach employs a differential op amp, okay, differential op amp along with two sampling capacitor shown over here at node X and node Y, so that the charge injected by S2 and S2 dash appear as a common mode disturbance at node X and Y. So this is a simple unity gain sampler or buffer in the case of discrete time. So we have shown that when we have used switches S1, S2, S3 to turn sampling mode to switch amplification mode, there are small error introduced by the switch on timing. So we have resolved that using this clock edges and differential realization of unity gain amplifier. So this is all about unity gain sampler or buffer. In the next lecture, we will start discussing about this non-inverting amplifier. Thank you.